apparently the Canadian dollar is really high today. It says at 80 cents. Does that mean everyone's gonna go shopping south of the border now? I always found that weird when people go to the US to shop, even though it technically, for some people, would cost them more just in terms of the travel and the time. I don't know, I guess some people don't really put in the math. It's all emotional in many ways. Although sometimes things like the electronics are really cheap there compared to here. It seems like we have like such a markup for some reason. What the heck is this? I guess someone unfortunately passed away, I'm guessing. That's what it seems like. Wonder what's up, but there's all these cop cars, a thing there, a bunch of like cameras. What's going on here? Yeah, you can't get away from all those Pokemon Go players. And holy cow, just from socializing with people, I didn't realize. Like, I was wondering what all those flowers and stuff was. Apparently in the news, there was a 13-year-old girl's body was found there before. I was like, holy smokes. Things you learn just for going on walks, huh? And it's just one of those things you never expect to happen, I guess, around your own area and stuff like that. And that just makes me think again. I mean, stupid people do stupid things. I don't care what it is. Like I said before, don't people have better things to do with their time than just try to harm others and all that? Speaking of kids, I actually read one piece of news today. I thought it would actually divide, for example, people who fly drones or model aircrafts. It had to do with safety. According to this, there was a model aircraft flying near a playground, and I guess for whatever reason, it crashed, and it crashed near like a child. And so because of that, apparently people in the city, like here in Richmond, there's parents basically asking people to stop flying there. Like, that's what they want anyways. But apparently this is actually one of the very few places people can actually fly. And of course, their kind of argument is, well, it's dangerous. I mean, look how hard it crashed into the ground. Imagine if that, you know, pierced through the child or something like that. But at the same time, apparently that's not the first time something's crashed. Like, just not too long ago, something crashed, like, above, I guess, in a school building as well, and they had to retrieve it. Oh, change of lighting and stuff, huh? I just got caught up with some stuff, so I just finally got a chance to continue my conversation I wanted to talk about. So where was I? Basically, from what I gathered from this, they're basically suggesting that they stop, I guess, flying the model aircrafts around that area. Like, they're not calling for a ban, but just they think it's unsafe to be around the playground. There was actually 2 points about this story that kind of interests me anyways, because with the laws, like with the drone laws in Canada, as you guys know, with the interim laws, like certain clubs were exempt or you were encouraged to join them because, I guess, because of their reputation, as the transport minister says. This was actually part of a club, to my understanding, like this field. So they were sanctioned and licensed, so they were actually doing everything okay, to my understanding. Well, I guess in this situation, I guess you can say they had one rogue pilot or something like that. Like, I don't know exactly what went wrong. But I kind of looked at the maps of the areas where they could fly, and this is kind of the interesting thing for me. And I think this is what I said, like, there might be a division on this issue. Because I was looking at the map of this club in relation to where they were flying and where they're supposed to fly. You can kind of see here, like, that's kind of odd. Isn't that really close to, like, the swings and the playgrounds and all that to have as a flying area? There could be some kind of technical detail I'm not aware of. Like, maybe the park says, well, you can't have all the area there, otherwise it stops, like, other people from playing sports or whatever. Maybe that's the case. But again, it made me think, well, you know, in cases like this, you know, accidents happen. That's just the way it is. And it's kind of an example for me personally to say, like, you know, just because you have a club or some kind of paper, like, things happen, I guess you can say. So there shouldn't be any type of bias saying this guy should be exempt, whereas this guy shouldn't. But one of the things that always gets a reaction out of me is how people always say things like, think of the kids, it's so dangerous, one, like, of this happening or whatever, that crash could, like, kill a child. But I'm just thinking about it, like, in terms of playgrounds. I mean, even with a very, very, like, quick search, like, I even know, like, there's probably injuries in playgrounds all the time not related to stuff like this. And sure enough, there is. it just comes to a matter of like, what is like an acceptable risk in terms of people? Like, in my opinion, like those type of accidents, like if that news report is accurate, where that club says they haven't, you know, got any accidents or whatever, like all those years, like isn't it the same thing as someone throwing a baseball? Like maybe there will be a freak accident that someone gets hit by it and gets injured, but that's more of the exception as opposed to the rule. So it made me wonder, like, how does everyone else feel about that? Because I think that's going to be a divided issue in many ways. Because you could argue, just like I said there, like, hey, it's no different than, say, like, a baseball or something like that. So, you know, it should be the same thing. But at the same time, there could be some people saying, like, well, it shouldn't be that close to the playground either. For me, again, like, I fly mostly, like, you know, quadcopters, drones or whatever, more for photography reasons. So they're really still in terms of, like, speed. It's slow as opposed to going more for the adrenaline rush. So I don't know, that's something for people to debate about, I think. But I think that's, like, you know, an important topic as well. Maybe someone out there understands model aircraft better than me, but again, I don't understand how come they designed it this way, like with the field in terms of where they could fly. Like, again, I would think anyways it would be better just to fly within that soccer field or whatever there, like use that entire space instead. Let's try to get some flight in. Probably won't need any darker filters, obviously. Let's see how it goes. Cow, again, it always seems so much darker than it actually is. Just for the heck of it, for the test, I just bumped up the ISO just so you guys can see what it's like when you bump it up too high, because I just didn't have time to fly it during the brighter day today. Anyways, see you guys later.